Hey everybody, it's Chuck Miller. It is June the 30th, 2012. It's a beautiful Saturday summer day in Albany. And I think I'm going to take this time to go out and work on a brand new art project. Want to come with me?
Here we are in the back room of the Historic Albany Foundation's Parts and Architectural Warehouse. As you can see, there's acres and acres and acres of windows and doors and parts. You need something to really accentuate your place? Get a new window to replace the old one? Instead of having to go to the parts where to the Home Depot to get it, you can get it at a place like this. And as I'm walking through all the windows and doors and architectural pieces, I came across this thing. Well, as you can see, I did actually purchase this window. And as you can see, it looks filthy. Would you believe that's actually glass in there and it's not some sort of charcoal colored wood? I did some measurements on it already. It's approximately 25 by 36 with 9 panes of glass, which I'm going to be taking out and replacing either with plate glass or colored glass. And we're gonna go through the entire steps on how to turn this filthy looking window into a nice looking piece of art. So what we did now is we've laid the window on a towel and we're gonna clean it off because God knows what kind of dirt is on this unit. God knows how many years it's been sitting someplace. So the best thing to do, first of all, is to wash it down with some pine cleaner and water. And as you can see, the dirt comes right up. God knows how much effort this will take, but in the end, you're going to have a much cleaner product. I mean, you can see right off the bat, I've just done 2 strokes. And what used to be a pink sponge is now almost pitch black. Ugh. Okay, as you can see, after some cleaning, we can actually see through some of the windows. Now, what we're going to do at this point is remove these windows and mark them and measure them, because we're going to be replacing almost every pane in here with either clean glass or colored glass. As you can see from this pane, the old putty is pretty much dried up and easy to remove. Just use a putty knife. You can pretty much wedge it in there and get all the gunk out. Now, as you go along, you're gonna see things like these little triangles. They're glazier's points. And just take your putty knife and you can wiggle them out. And then once you loosen them, they come right out. Put these somewhere safe. You do not want to step on them. I am not kidding, it hurts. This is 4 inches. About 4 inches square. I took out a couple more panes. As you can see, this long one, which will be window pane number 6, is 4 inches across by a little less than 24 inches. This bottom pane, which is pane 8, is 4 inches by just a little less than 14 inches, maybe an eighth of an inch less on both sides. This pane here, which is pane number 5, this is our center pane, as you can see, there's a nasty crack. So I have to be very careful in removing this, but because the pane itself is at least 75-80% intact, I can still measure this on all 4 sides and get the dimensions. And if this was broken,
I could still take the long dimension from this and the long dimension from this and automatically figure out that this pane is at least a little less than 14 inches across by just a smidge less than 24 inches long. So you can see here we've got another type of glazier's points. They don't always come in triangle shapes. They sometimes come in these little points with a bracing part to it. So as I said, be very careful when you're pulling these things out. They can fall on the floor. You can step on them. It will hurt. So here's the window with all the panels removed, and I think for all intents and purposes, I'm going to set this window up in a vertical portrait style. Now, in order to make sure that I have everything the way I want it, I've noted that the drill hole at the top of panel 2 will be at the top of the picture, and the hole that's on the right of panel 6, which might either be a handle or a small doorknob or a fastener, will be where it is now. And I will build the picture from this orientation. So what am I going to do with this window? Well, the upper panels, panel 1 and panel 3, which are upper left and upper right, I'm going to replace with some swirled stained glass. Now, this piece here is cut 4 inches by 4 inches. I had it cut at a local stained glass repair and manufacturing shop in Albany. You might have one in your town, or you can go to your local hobby store or glass center to find out more information on where to get a piece like this. This is going to go into panel 1, and as you can see, it's beautifully swirled with little burgundy and beautiful lines and swirls on it. That's going to be panel 1. Panel 3 is going to be this beautiful blue one. Now, this one I got at my local Hobby Lobby, and I actually had this one cut at the same stained glass company. That's going to go over here. And the next step, I'm going to show you how to put these in and how to make sure they stay secure. Okay, I've laid my window down on the floor, and this is the panel that's going into panel 3. So you can see I want to make sure that the swirls are straight up like this and keep the curve like this. Now, if I just leave this in like this and hang it up, the window's going to fall out in like 2 seconds. So I'm going to take these glazier's points and I'm going to use them to brace the picture. I'm going to take my putty knife and just work them into the wood. Wiggle them so gently until they're flush with the panel. Okay, now I'm going to take my putty and just work it until it's nice and pliable, almost like Play-Doh. And I'm going to make a rope out of it. I'm going to put the rope right in this crevice between the glass and the wood. Take our putty knife, and I'm just going to pack it in. Whoops, loose putty knife. Pack it in, like so. And then, just to trim it off, just a little. Remember, this window is not going to be used to, you know, protect you from the elements. It's not going to get stuck in the side of a house. This is probably going to be hung on a wall. So all we need to do is make sure that the pane is secure. Okay, as you can see, we've gotten panel 3, which is the blue stained glass panel, all puttied up. It's going to take about 24 hours for the putty to dry, so I'm just going to leave it here. But I did want to show you that I actually took care of panel 1 as well. That's the champagne burgundy smoked glass. And that's also been wood puttied up. You're gonna end up with a little bit of touch up here and there. You just have to
clean it up and understand that that's going to happen.
And hey, look, this is what it looks like from the front. Very impressive. Two panels down, seven to go. Okay, we've put the colored glass into the window. Now let's start putting in some artwork. This picture right here is a picture I took a few weeks ago, and it's of a railroad bridge as it spans a small river. What I'm going to do is put this in as panel number two. I've already had a piece of cut glass at the same dimension, so that'll protect this artwork. First, we'll put in the pane of glass that will protect our artwork, and then we'll put the artwork in. Make sure you put it in right side up, or people will laugh. And you don't want people laughing at your artwork. I want to show you something. You can use glaziers points and putty to put your artwork into the window. If it's a large enough area, you can use one of these things. This is a Logan Dual Driver Elite Glazier Point installation device. It looks like a staple gun. You can get it at most craft stores. AC Moore, Michaels has them, or go to your independent craft store and they can either special order it for you or they might have it on the shelves. It works just like a staple gun. You simply put your point directly up close to the wood and fire. Now this thing is bolted in tight. You can do it with this one too. Okay, this is good. You don't even need to use putty for this because these are rigid points and they will not bend out unless you like take a screwdriver and really force it. So now for panel number seven. Again, we have another picture that I've taken. This is of a railroad crossing in Albany County. It's just a plain looking crossing sign. What I'm going to do with this picture is actually place it behind some amber glass. I've had this cut at 4 inches by 4 inches. And like the railroad bridge before it, I'm going to install this into our window, and the amber glass will not only protect the railroad sign, it'll also accentuate it. Okay, again, we have the amber glass. Just to drop right in there. Make sure when you put these in, you put them in right side up. You don't want to have to take them apart a second time. And we'll just take our little glazier point staple gun. Just pop this in. Now you gotta admit, that's impressive. Looks great inside the glass, looks great inside the frame. Four panels down, five to go. While most of our panels are either going to be stained glass or they're going to be pictures behind clear glass, I want to show you what I'm going to do with panel six. Panel six is going to be very special. What we have here is a cardboard cutout, and this is at the dimensions of 4 inches wide by 23 7/8 inches long. That's going to be the spot for panel six. Now, a piece of black cardboard is not going to be very attractive. So what we're going to do is we're going to add this burled wood veneer to it. Now, burled wood, if you've never seen burled wood before, it's actually thin sheets of wood that's either been from damaged trees or trees that have had some sort of fungal growth to them. And the intricate, curled, swirled pieces of burled wood are fantastic for people who want to refinish cabinets or use it for marquetry. What I'm going to do is take a portion of this burled wood, I'm going to trim it to the dimensions of the cardboard, and then I'm going to combine the two together. Okay, here's our burled wood veneer, and it's adhered to the backing board. This is going to be panel six in our window. Now, I could simply put that in as is, and it'd be okay. But since I'm working with a railroad motif, what I did was I went to my local hobby store, my local train hobby store, and I purchased this. This is a piece of N-scale train track, and I'm just going to bend it. This is flexible track. I'm going to bend it so that it follows the curve of this little burling here. Okay? I'm just going to bend it simply. And to adhere it, I'm going to thread some wire between some of these ties and pierce the back of the board. And that's going to make the track
hold on tight and keep the curve. Here we go. We now have a train track that's added to the burled wood panel. And I'll just bolt this directly in. I'm not going to add glass on this one just because I don't want the glass to fracture on the rail. So here's the window project as it's hanging on the wall currently. You can see that there's 5 panels installed. I'm waiting for the other 4 to be printed and foam boarded and delivered. So while I waited, I decided to set up the hanging wire, which I did. I also put some rubber adhesive stickers to the back of the picture so that it won't scrape the wall or sway or when somebody bumps into it. Again, we want to make sure that the artwork is pointed straight up. I thought you might appreciate seeing this before I install it. This is going to be the center panel, panel 5. It's a black and white photograph of a train going through North Albany, and I had it printed on metallic paper to really make it stand out. I'm just going to take this, slide it right into the center. Once this is in, I'll start popping in and you want to make sure you put these in at spots where you don't have the braces already in so that you're not pressing one in and accidentally popping another one out. And here's the final result. This is a dream window. Took me about a month to put together, and I'm really proud of how it came out. You can build one of these yourself just by following the instructions in this video. Visit your salvage yards, have good contact with hobby stores, glass companies, and photography shops. And with a little ingenuity, you too can build an art window that looks just as good as this, or even better. Thanks for watching this video. I'm Chuck Miller, and have a great day.